What's happening, y'all? First video of the summer. Hey, this is Rich Osweiler for PremierGuitar.com. I'm standing here with Barry Gresbeck for Gres Guitars. How's it going, good Barry?
Awesome. Great way to start the show.
Yeah.
So I see you've got a new baritone in tow.
Absolutely. It's been a good year with the Mendocino. So this year we've launched it in a baritone version. Okay. Same guitar, same kind of cool vintage tone, but 28 and a half inch scale.
Okay.
So for folks who may not have seen the video for the standard Mendocino, you want to take us through the accoutrements here on the baritone or that?
This happens to be a standard Mendocino, but nonetheless, the details are the same. It's a salvaged old growth redwood top. So this comes from Northern California, from old barns and train tunnels and wherever I can get it.
Okay.
The body is a one-piece mahogany blank. The neck is one piece as well.
Okay.
So all Honduran mahogany, it's all quite light, very hollowed out. So this thing weighs 5 pounds. The baritone is maybe 5.5.
Okay.
So it's super light instrument, super lively. It's really designed similar to how an acoustic guitar might be designed. So it's got a really good voice, which is why it lends itself so well to being a baritone. It can really sing with those lower notes, those extra harmonics you get from the baritone scaling.
Right on. Who makes the pickups?
Jason Lawler.
Very nice.
Yeah, they're single coils. They're surprisingly quiet for single coils. I think just because they're in a metal box that's grounded, they're really studio friendly as single coils go, I think.
Yeah.
And the baritone itself has a unique voice for a baritone. It is not your typical Dano sound. I mean, that's kind of that classic tone people recognize. But this is a little more lush, a little more complex, and kind of fits into a mix a little easier, I think. I think sometimes with some of the baritones out there, you have to do a little bit of EQ on them to get them to really fit. I mean, it might be a cool demo, but in a band setting, they take some work. And this is voiced so that it just kind of works. It's ready to go. It fits into the band setting nice. If you have other guitars in the mix, it's going to work around those. It's not on top of them.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a good sound, I think.
What are we looking at for costs and availability?
$2,800.
Okay.
$3,000 with a tremolo on it.
Okay.
This one has a Bigsby on it. Actually, future models are all going to have TK Smiths on there.
Okay.
And so that's an extra $200.
Okay.
And we're making them in stock in black and natural.
Okay.
I happen to have a burst just because, I don't know, just because it amused me, right? But generally black and natural. But we can still do custom colors without too much extra lead time, because there's always guitars in process, and pulling one aside and putting a little different color on, it's no big deal. The other thing that's going to be new for both the regular Mendocino and the baritone is they're going to be available as lefties starting this month.
And is there an add-on for that?
No add-on cost.
Right on.
And the big thing that makes it a lefty is getting new tail pieces that look right in that orientation. Otherwise,
yeah,
the guitar is basically the same.
Sure.
But yeah, exactly. You want the lefties to look right too.
Right.
Well, cool. Well, RJ, why don't you take us through some tones here? Let's hear some different configurations. So Barry, where can folks find out more information about your guitars?
GrezGuitars.com, G-R-E-Z, guitars.com.
That's easy. Hey y'all, well, Barry, thank you.
You bet, appreciate being the first one of the whole show. That's awesome.
Cool, well, there's gonna be a whole lot more coming, so be sure to tune in to PremierGuitar.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and all that other good stuff. We're here for 3 more days, and there's a lot of things to see. Thanks again.